What's up, my folks? How's everyone doing today? Hope everyone's doing good, hanging out, and everything's okay. Been working my ass off. I've been getting a lot of emails and pictures I went through this morning. I bet you America's gonna have the finest jog yards in the world when this pandemic's over. Everybody's doing yard work and getting all their shit right. It's looking good, guys. Keep yourself busy. That's what I've been doing too. All my fruit trees are popping. It's just like a real blessing. I got more peaches on that thing. And that's just a blessing. All my fruit trees. I'm going to put me a little cedar tree in there. I think I'm going to put it up there for shade for this spot. But let's go over here and bull skate a minute. I want to give a shout out to Buck City. I see you're back up and running. That's a good thing. That's a real good thing. It's a good thing for the whole fraternity. I hope your attorneys grab them by their ankles and flip them upside down and shake them till the change falls out their pocket, cuz. But I hope it all works out good for you, in seriousness. But anyway, I hope you guys are being really safe. We're praying for you guys in the city. For y'all that don't believe in the big G, I do, and I'll pray for you. Let's put it that away. But there is one thing I wanted to say. You know, we get emails and talk to people and stuff from all over. And Miss Kay, she knows a lot of higher-ups in the medical field and stuff, and cleans houses for them and stuff like that. And I do know this. I want to pass this along. Don't be messing with no Advil. There's something going on with Advil and the number of people that had complications if they did get it. But I'm hoping my folks are diligent enough to stay away from the whole thing altogether. Smart enough to realize what parvo is. But anyway, oh, and wanted to tell the folks about the hides. Don't order no more hides, guys. I can't even get into the post office. It's impossible. I really don't want to go down there anyway. All them people in line and hanging out and shit, I'm just going to have to ride this one out a little bit. And don't order no shirts, because I don't know when I'll be able to go down there either. We shut down too. They went ahead and voluntarily shut pretty much everything that's non-essential down. And they're only doing one person at a time in. So, you know, they're taking it serious finally. You know, no one took shit serious. They don't take, no, it's a big party. You know what I mean? But anyway, it is what it is. It's going to do what it's going to do. We just got to see how it rides out. And y'all watch and see how people act on this. But, you know, what kind of bullshit gets slid in the, you know, the shell game, like the cup. Which one's got the ball in it. You know, that's the shit they play with us. So next time we have some bullshit come up that where they can say we got a martial law and quarantine, they can disarm us and fucking make you go into a certain spot, and so they can keep control of you because people can't stay home. You know, that'll be the next excuse. So be careful when we vote our fucking, let them vote our damn rights away over a little $1,200, $2,000 check or what the fuck ever. You know what I'm saying? Y'all be careful about that shit. I know it's already done, but y'all pay attention and see who does what now. But anyway, come here. Them flies getting on you. I just sprayed you with fly spray. But anyway, I want to talk a little bit about bloodlines. I seen I had some questions about a few bloodlines. One being the Andy Cap. We'll start there. If I had to say any bloodline as a strain, the Andy Cap. You know, I'm from Andy Cap World, Voodooville. You know, I would say the Andy Cap dogs have improved in the last 10, 12 years more than any other strain I've seen. You know, they've really made an improvement. I have had dogs real close and, you know, right off of Red Johnny and stuff like that, you know. And they were, they were only, you know, seven type dogs. They were good, a good foundation to work with. And the guys that took that blood, they knew that, you know, that it was a good foundation. They built off that and they added what they needed to make them dogs good. But yeah, that's one of the strains I can say has probably done the most improvement that I can think of in the last, you know, 10, 12 years probably. But it's a good strain to work with. Now, I mean, the dogs might not be pure, you know what I mean? I don't like anything too much pure, but for performance wise, you know, but you know, they've done cross that shit right and made it work. Any of the faults, a lot of them guys have fixed them. You know, that's just the thing. A lot of the faults have been fixed in those bloods. Come here, boy. Come here. But, you know, and like people are saying about the Red Boy, I've seen some comments about Red Boy is game but don't bite. Man, that's a myth. That's another myth, since we're on bloodlines and people are asking how to work mouth and stuff like that. Some dogs have mouth and some don't. That's bottom line. I've seen plenty of hard biting red boy dogs. I mean, shit, them britches dogs could bite, cuz, real good. So could a lot of the Burns blood. So could a lot of Mr. Cruz's blood. You know, them dogs can bite. Some of it was crossed, but I mean, they got mouth. I mean, if your dog ain't biting, it ain't the bloodline. It might be the individual strain ain't throwing mouth, or the producer ain't throwing mouth. And sometimes mouth jumps around, you know. But just because you got to breed to a hard mouth dog don't mean the whole litter's going to come like mouth. Like him, he don't bite near as hard as his brother. I mean, he still bites good. I'd say he's probably about an 8 mouth. But his brother's like a freak. You know what I'm saying? It is a freak mouth. You know what I'm saying? That shit just, he just has it. It ain't like, you can't work it. Like a lot of them dogs, you know, like you say, you got just an average, like a 5 mouth dog. That's just a pretty much hardly can't bust a great kind of dog. You know what I mean? Just a regular average mouth dog. You ain't going to turn him into no 7 by doing a little bit of work with his mouth. I mean, there is things you can do, but see, when you get a dog like that's biting like a 7, you know, that's pretty fair mouth, and you can work that shit out of them too. You know what I'm saying? What you want to teach your dog to do with mouth work is just teach him how to breathe with his mouth closed. That's all you need to do. The dog isn't, I mean, we used to take tires, like, you know, 13-inch, like nylon belted tires, and hang them up and wrap them in duct tape, where the dog could learn how to bite and hang on and pinch, you know, get on in there with it. And it helped a little bit, you know, but it ain't going to turn, no, like I said, no 5 mouth into a 7, and it ain't going to turn a 7 into a 9, you know. And then when you get into the good mouth dogs, you got more of a risk fucking with their mouth and messing it up. What if they fucking break a tooth, or, you know, pull something loose, or, you know, and like that tug on the spring pole where they're pulling on the spring, that's more of a body workout than a mouth. I mean, my house dog, she don't have no real bone crusher mouth, and she bites hard. She's probably one of the hardest biting ones in that litter, but she still ain't gonna be no damn, it don't make her bite any harder, and she can do that shit probably 3 hours, man, when she's in good shape. So, I mean, it's just, it don't make them bite any harder. It just teaches them how to bite with their mouth closed. You know what I'm saying? That's what that mouth work does. Either the dog's got it or they don't. That's all that matters in this world of dogs, is either they can or they can't. That's just the facts. I mean, you know, a lot of dogs, I mean, people think they got a dog that can bite until they really see one that can bite. I thought I seen as hard as humanly possible until this year with Bullet. I mean, I thought I seen, there was no way. Some of the dogs I've seen would blow your mind, and he blew my mind. You know what I'm saying? Which, at first time, I thought it was kind of a freak accident thing. You know, because the hog guy thought maybe did it because they were so rough. You know, I thought maybe he broke his own fucking jaw like that, till I really got to looking, you know. But, you know, some dogs can, some can't. Like Rusty, he's got pretty good mouth of them. A litter of dogs that all got pretty good mouth. Now, Rusty bites pretty hard. I'd say he's a good 8 mouth, you know. For his size, he might even bite harder than that. But his sister, the Riri bitch, that bitch can bite, like, real hard. Like, probably a 9, you know. And she does good, you know. And that's another thing I was getting at. It's like the size of their head and all that shit don't seem to make a difference. It really don't. I mean, I'm sure if you start your dog every day on a fucking something for mouth work over for a year, it might make turning from a 5 to a 7, you know, or something like that. But in the real world of things, either a dog can bite or he can't. You know what I'm saying? That's just all there is to it. But anyway, you guys, I hope y'all are staying safe and staying diligent. And my dogs are just chilling. I'm just doing improvements on my yard, taking care of shit. You know how we roll down here. I'm damn sure staying out of places, though. That shit is popping up around here like fucking herpes at a strip club, man. These motherfuckers just thought it was a big joke, you know. But anyway, y'all folks, y'all take care and keep on bulldogging.